The Lord be with you.
Good morning, everyone, to the house of the Lord. This is a great opportunity for everybody to share God's word. What a beautiful experience to see your faces. To see your faces. This sounds so simple, but it's just so beautiful to see your faces. Let us do an exercise of breathing. Remember that we are in this sermon series about breathing. So let us take a deep breath. Hold it. One more time. Hold it. Now, as we breathe, let us keep in our minds and our souls the following thoughts. Breathe in peace. So exhale and let go of your anxiety. So breathe now in God's hope and exhale and let go of your fear. So breathe in God's joy and exhale and let go of your sorrow. And finally, breathe in God's love and exhale and let go of your negativity. Let's do it. Let's have some moments of silence. So let us breathe and let us worship together. So now I invite you to stand up for the call to worship.
Think about the faces we hardly know. Strangers, sojourners, forgotten friends, the ones who need an outstretched hand. People of God, consider all the images of God reflected in these familiar, unfamiliar, and unknown faces. In me, in you, in each of us, God's Spirit shines for all to see. People of God, come. Let us join our voices in praise to the God who gathers us and feeds us.
Thank you.
Please join me in our unison prayer. Eternal One, whose thoughts and ways are not ours, you alone are God, awesome, holy, and most high. School us in the ways of faith and wisdom, that we, like the prophet Job, may learn to truly see and hear, and in humility find blessing. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, what a great opportunity to offer signs of peace. So we're going to turn around and say hello to our neighbors. So let me say it. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let's have signs of peace.
Yeah.
One of the blessings that we have as a church is that we can pray for each other. So I invite you to check the prayer list that is on the last page of the bulletin. So let us pray at this time. Lord, we come here today in fellowship with one another, setting aside this time just for you, to offer you praise and worship and to hear you speak to us, and to live here shaped a little bit more into the likeness of Jesus Christ. So we come humbly and quietly before you, praying, O Lord, for the many blessings that we have received. We give thanks for the gift of breath and life itself. We pray, O Lord, for those who find so difficult to breathe because of difficult circumstances that weighed upon them. We pray, O Lord, for all of those in our congregation who are experiencing their own difficult times. We pray, O Lord, for healing. We pray, O Lord, for comfort and for peace and guidance that you can give us, O Lord, the challenge of trusting you, especially in difficult moments as we exceed 4 million deaths around the world and 600,000 in the U.S. So we pray for those who are grieving the loss of loved ones and those who are still battling the virus. And we pray all of this, O Lord, because we trust you, because you are our God, and because this is the reason that we are here, worshiping you, praising you with all our minds and our hearts, but also this morning with all our lungs. And as we use our voice to praise you, we can also open them to pray this beautiful prayer that you taught to your disciples by saying, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen."
Hear these words from the book of Job. Job again took up his discourse and said, "As God lives, who has taken away my right, and the Almighty, who has made my soul bitter? As long as my breath is in me, and the Spirit of God is in my nostrils, my lips will not speak falsehood, and my tongue will not utter deceit. Far be it from me to say that you are right. Until I die, I will not put away my integrity from me. I hold fast my righteousness and will not let it go. My heart does not reproach me for any of my days." This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God. We started this morning by breathing, and I would like to ask you, what did you feel? So remember, we breathe for God because of God breathed on us. And God breathed on us with his mercy, and he breathed on us with his forgiveness, and he breathed on us with grace. So today we enter into the second part of our sermon series called Breathe, the divine gift of becoming a living being. And today the theme invites us to reflect on the life of one of the most great characters in the Bible, Job. A man who has been studied by many theologians, by many scholars, by many people in churches, because he was a faithful man and a patient man in the eyes of God. But Job doesn't just meet those decorations. He was also a man of integrity. Integrity is the condition of an individual or an object to maintain all parts of him in this case. So this doesn't include any of the physical, but the values and convictions. That is to say, it can be affirmed that a person is whole when he acts according to the ideas that he has always expressed, even in difficult times. So in the Old Testament, the term, which comes from the Hebrew language, is translated in the following way. Is to be complete. To be complete, not divided or with missing parts. Is to be whole. But the meaning of this word goes beyond this etymological meaning. The word also has the idea of a person classified as integral is the person who has exhausted all his strength. Do you remember the Apostle Paul? When he says, I press on toward the goal for the prize of the heavenly call of God in Christ Jesus. That is the idea of integrity. To go for, non-stop. So integrity means thinking and doing the right thing at all times, regardless of the consequences. When you have integrity, you are willing to live by the standards and beliefs even when no one is watching. Whoa, that's difficult. That's difficult. Is to have that harmony between what people see and what people don't see. If you have integrity, the saying, Do what I say and not what I do, doesn't work here. So when do we consider someone like that? One way is when a particular person is in a limiting situation, in a very complicated situation, in a time of decision. In a time of a difficult and complicated moment in his life. But still there, this person maintains his moral maintains, his ethics maintains, his spiritual life maintains, his life principles. That is what happened to Job. Imagine a man sitting on the ground, covered in painful ulcers from head to toe, and he is hunched over, his head down, and no one accompanies him, and he does not even have the energy to scare away the flies approaching him. To show his grief, he is sitting on ashes, something that was very common of pain and mourning and suffering in many ancient cultures. And all what Job is doing, and he has left, is to scratch his sore skin with a piece of clay pot. This man has lost so much in every way. The truth is, he couldn't be worse. His friends, his neighbors, and relatives had abandoned him. Everyone, even the children, makes fun of him. Job believes that his God has turned his back on him. But he has not realized that God is still with him. Remember, to be whole, to be complete, to be integral, it doesn't mean that you are perfect. There are two different things. This man whom God said there was no one like him on earth suffers and struggles to continue being faithful to God. It's not that same struggle that we do have. And Job says, as long as my breath is in me and the Spirit of God is in my nostrils, my lips will not speak falsehood. Do you remember from last Sunday's sermon, we talked about breathing only for God? It's very difficult for me to breathe now because Mr. Martin shared a nice cold with me. And so I'm trying to breathe. And you remember that, breathing and feeling God's presence, not only in the good moments of your life, of our lives, but also in the difficult moments. And that's difficult. I remember when my father was days away from death, the pain caused by his bone cancer was very severe. Even though he was on morphine, it seemed like it wasn't enough. And there was a great uncertainty in the whole family during those days. Because we saw that our father and our father's breathing was ending. It was like a candle that extinguishes its light. And amid the pain, it was a constant hearing and a constant words saying, God, have mercy on me. Take this pain away. God, have mercy on me. Take this pain away from me. And it was over and over and over, and he was saying exactly the same words over and over. And in my humanity, as a son, I thought, I said to myself, how does someone who is suffering in this way not deny God? Instead, it simply exalts God by asking for mercy. But when we all know that life turns 1,000 times, I had a similar experience in my time of illness. When I was in the hospital with oxygen 24/7 and there was uncertainty because I did not see progress in my recovery, I must confess that more than separating myself from God and feeling that God had abandoned me, I felt the certainty that God was there. And my prayers were more constant. My thoughts of God and His mercy for me were more latent. Moreover, this sermon series was thought and was designed in those difficult moments of health. And I thought many times in my life in that bed, as long as my breath is in me and the Spirit of God is in my nostrils, my lips will not speak falsehood. I wonder if you have had an experience similar to this one, or perhaps right now you are facing difficulties and misfortunes. And as a pastor, I could easily say to you, hey, brother, sister, read the book of Job. This story can comfort you. This story can help you. But brothers and sisters, biblical meditation is not like an aspirin that we must take and fix our headaches. To reflect, we have to experience, so that later we can bear witness to the wonders that God has done in us. Remember, to have a testimony, we need to have a test, and we need to be tested. So I ask you, in difficult moments of despair, of sickness and trial, can you breathe with integrity before God's eyes? Can you feel that God is still there with you and that God has not abandoned you? Meditate well on your answer, because it is not an easy thing to answer. Look at the life of Job. How difficult must it have been for Job not to know if God was there for him, feeling that his family was no longer there for him, that his friends judged him and left him, knowing that he lost everything. But Job didn't know that God was giving him a great opportunity to prove that Satan was wrong. Did I say Satan? Wow, that's very weird for a Methodist pastor to speak about Satan. Satan was allowed to take from Job everything he had. The only thing he couldn't do was hurt him physically. And I know that many times it is difficult for us to understand the mysteries of God. Still, the question is, what is left for us to do in those moments of uncertainty? What do we do when we have lost our jobs? What do we do when our spouse has passed away and we feel alone? What do we do when cancer affects us and we don't see physical recovery? What do we do? What do we do, Lord? What do we do? Job, with integrity, reaffirms his faith in the Creator, alluding to the act of breathing as a symbol of life. Do you remember the text from last Sunday? Then the Lord God formed man from the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and the man became a living being. So Job knew that if God has given him life, he could not deny his existence. It is as if someone gave us something and we ungratefully return it, because we consider we don't want it. How do you feel? Human beings demonstrate our complete integrity when we remain faithful and continue to do God's will despite difficulties. That is why today, friends, I urge you, maybe living in this very moment during that situation, remember to breathe. Yes, to breathe. Physiologically speaking, breathing helps us to remove carbon dioxide and cleans our lungs with clean and fresh air. So that's breathing for God. The breath, spiritually speaking, is to remove what is contaminated in our hearts and breathe in integrity. It is to be whole, to be complete, not to be divided or in missing parts. It is not to be among a pseudo-Christian that deceives us. Having integrity means to breathe God. Having integrity means believing in His will, knowing that we cannot be breathed by what happens to us and deny God, who is our Creator. Jesus is the perfect example of integrity. After being baptized, you remember that he went to the desert and Satan tried, but didn't work. God, Jesus' integrity was just something that it's difficult for us to understand. Jesus is the only one who never sinned, perfect, totally truthful, and always showing a model of good works. So friends, breathe and don't let go your integrity. So may God strengthen you so that in those moments of uncertainty that you are probably living now, you can still stand firm in integrity, knowing that even if you don't see God, God is still there for you. So breathe and don't let go your integrity.
called to use all that we are and all that we have to build the kingdom of God among us. Charlton Church has been a faithful family of faith for over 200 years, who have strived to do whatever we can to reach out in love and compassion to all who are in need. Let us make our offerings with a cheerful heart, trusting that God will do great things through our lives. God of breath and life itself, you abide with us. You provide for all our needs and guide us in your ways. Out of gratitude for your care, we bring our gifts before you. Use them for your work of caring, that all may feast at the table of abundance. Walk without fear and drink deeply from the cup of compassion. Amen.
Thank you.
a beautiful morning. So let us receive now the benediction of the Lord. Therefore, my beloved sisters and brothers, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. Go, breathe, and don't let go your integrity. Amen.